there's an update to seeing AI. So let's dig in and find out more about it. Hi everyone, welcome to Carrie on Accessibility, where we explore technology and accessibility. After receiving an email that there was an update for Seeing AI on both iOS and Android, and that you can share MP4s and have them described, I just had to check it out. So if you want to check it out as well, go to your App Store or the Play Store and update Seeing AI. So now I'm on a Pixel 8 Pro. After updating it, I'm gonna open.
Open. Short text. What's new?
Let's see what's
Bullet,
new.
2160. Alt,
fra. Okay, it's reading my keyboard. We'll just ignore that.
Bullet. Seeing AI can now describe videos. Share an MP4 file with Seeing AI and hear it described scene by scene. Bullet. You can now recognize PDF documents with Seeing AI.
Ooh, cool.
Bullet. After tapping more info to get a rich description of an image, you can now ask questions on the same screen.
Okay, that is helpful so that we don't have to go through many buttons.
Bullet. Reduce the amount of time it takes to get a rich description or answers to your questions. Bullet. On the product channel, both barcodes and enhanced QR codes can now be recognized at the same time.
Enhanced QR codes. I wonder what those are. Are those like Navilens codes or something?
Bullet. Plus various bug fixes under the hood. Okay?
Let's...
Document. Product. Scene preview.
Okay, let's move over to scene then. Let's see what we've got here.
Quick help. Take picture.
There doesn't seem to be a way to upload a picture from here. Or a video. Okay, let's take a picture.
Processing. Collect several children's drawings on a whiteboard. Seeing AI.
Okay, it's not a whiteboard, it's just a wall, but that's okay.
Several children's draw. Explore photo. Share. Save photo. More info.
Let's go to more info.
Processing. Close. Ask Scene AI.
I'm not sure if that was faster. What do you guys think?
Ask Scene AI. Feedback. Seeing AI. The image shows a collection of children's drawings displayed on a white surface.
It gave a pretty nice description, but the description was a little too long for this video. What's nice is that with the update, as soon as you hit more info, it takes you directly to where you can ask a question. So it has the edit box at the bottom. It also fixed the contrast for the messages that Seeing AI gives you, and now it's like white on a black or very dark gray background, and so that is definitely a welcome improvement. I still wish that it could automatically read the answers for you without talkback. That would be a great feature. Since there wasn't a way to upload directly in the Seeing AI app, I went to photos and I'm going to share a video that way. Let's try this one.
Video taken on October 25th, 20. Skip backwards.
Okay.
Share.
We're gonna share this.
Share. Seeing AI. Seeing AI.
Okay, let's share photos. It with Seeing AI.
Video description. Video description. Seeing AI can describe videos from various applications, including photos and WhatsApp. Just share the video and select Recognize with Seeing AI from the available actions.
Oh, okay.
Close. Processing. Please wait while descriptions for the video are generated. This may take several minutes depending on the length of the video. Close.
Several minutes. What is the maximum length, I wonder? This is going to be really interesting. I know other apps that can do this. So like Pixiebot, I think there's a 2-minute limit on there. And I'm just gonna keep talking while this runs because I kind of want to give you an idea of how long the processing actually takes, because I know that at least for Pixiebot, as long as it's under 2 minutes, it really doesn't take that long. It's definitely shorter than this one. But this is a 40 second, or no, actually it was 13 seconds. Oh, here we go.
A dog is standing indoors with a blue balloon attached to its collar. The dog is standing on its hind legs, reaching towards the blue balloon in a room with a dining table and chairs. The dog is standing on the floor, looking at the blue balloon in a room with a dining table and chairs. The dog is jumping towards the blue balloon in a room with a dining table and chairs. The dog is standing on the floor, looking at the blue balloon in a room with a dining table and chairs. The dog is standing indoors with a blue balloon attached to its collar, near a dining table and chairs.
Okay. Now let me give you my description. There are several balloons in this dining area. We had lots of balloons during a birthday party, lots of October birthdays in my family, and one of the streamers of balloons fell down, and there's like these balloons hanging down from the ceiling, and it's low enough that our dog just kept trying to jump for it and trying to jump for it and trying to jump for it, and she was really cute. But I just don't feel like it actually conveyed that through this description. It kind of did. You can kind of piece it together and understand what's going on. But that first description, it said that, you know, there's a blue balloon attached to her collar, and that's not true. I don't know. It feels like it just takes like little snapshots and describes the images, but like I don't actually know how this works, but it seems to be inserting those descriptions in between the video. So let's go ahead and try a different video. I just recorded a quick 11 second video of something quite random in my room with no audio basically, and so I'm gonna share it to seeing AI.
Processing. Please wait while descriptions for the video are generated. This may take several minutes depending on the length of the video. Close.
This time we'll skip the processing, but it did take about 45 seconds.
Seeing a shelf filled with various types of Rubik's cubes and other puzzle cubes. A shelf with a can of snacks and a green leafy plant. A green leafy plant in a wooden pot placed on a shelf. A pink and blue gradient water bottle on a shelf, with some candles and decorations in the background.
There's its description. It's not super descriptive for each scene, but at least this kind of gives you an idea. Let's see if it's able to read text in a video. This time I took a 19 second video of me going through about 4 different pages in a book, so let's see what seeing AI does. This time processing took about a minute.
Seeing a hand is holding open a book, showing pages with text and illustrations. The left page has a section titled Just a Minute, and the right page has a letter and some text. The book is open to pages with text and illustrations. The left page shows a boy lying on the floor, and the right page shows a family having a meal at a table. The book remains open to the same pages as the previous segment, with a boy lying on the floor on the left page and a family having a meal on the right page. The book is open to pages with text and an illustration of a boy holding apples on the right page. The book remains open to the same pages as the previous segment, with text and an illustration of a boy holding apples on the right page. A hand is turning the page of the book, revealing new pages with text and illustrations. The book is open to pages with text in a section titled Think About It and Just for Fun on the right page.
I'm a little disappointed that it didn't read what was on the page. I think that, you know, considering that it's seeing AI, you might as well read what you can see on the page, or at least have a way where you can kind of interrogate the AI about the video. Say, hey, could you read all the text that you saw in this video? Something like that. That would be really cool. And even just being able to ask the AI follow-up questions about the video would be super, super helpful. I think this is a really, really cool feature so far. However, I would love to see a way to send links. I don't know about you guys, but you know, I watch YouTube shorts or TikToks or Instagram, and you know, it's like a whole bunch of stuff going on and I have no idea. And most of the time I just skip over it. But if somebody sends me something, I'm just like, oh my gosh, there's so much text on the screen. It's moving too fast. I don't know what's happening. Especially when they leave that like one half a second like frame at the end that's supposed to be the punchline. Oh, I hate that because I can never pause on the right spot for it to like to look at it. I don't know if they do that on purpose. Maybe they do, because maybe I'm not the only one who struggles with that. I don't know. But I would love to be able to send links I could see so much potential in this, and this is an exciting update. Let me know what you think about the update, what you tried, what worked for you, how do you feel about this AI? Let me know in the comments. I also am curious if any of you have tried PixieBot out there, PicciBot, because it also has a video sharing feature. Let me know in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up below. Make sure you subscribe for more videos like this. And if you want to support the channel and the work that I do, consider becoming a YouTube or Patreon member. I have exclusive videos for members, and we have a meetup every month. Thanks everybody for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Bloopers. Hi everyone, welcome to Carrie on Accessibility, where we what do we do? That was a head desk. And have it described to us. And have it described. After reading an email that there is an update for iOS and Android. Not for iOS and Android, for Seeing AI.